Want to learn more about how the DELF A2 exam works? Watch this video, where I'll share an overview of the exam with you and I'll explain the format in detail, as well as the scoring for each of the four skills, so that you can understand what this exam entails. For all my best French lessons, learning tips, and simple step-by-step explanations, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell below to be notified every time I share a new video. Perhaps you're considering sitting an official French exam and you just want to know what the DELF A2 is all about. By the end of this video, you're going to have a detailed understanding of the entire exam with explanations on what to expect for each section. I'm Tavi Baisley, founder of French Speak, and I've had the pleasure to help tens of learners just like you sit and pass the DELF exam with great results. Alors, on commence? The duration of the exam is 1 hour and 40 minutes. It's made up of four parts: listening, reading, writing, and speaking. In French, we call them compréhension orale, compréhension écrite, production écrite, et production orale. Each part is worth 25 points, and in order to pass the exam and obtain this diploma, you need a total of 50 out of 100 points. You do need a minimum of 5 points per skill, so you have to score at least a handful of points for each part and not skip one completely. The first part is listening, so compréhension orale. Here, you will listen to 3 or 4 short recordings. In total, it lasts 25 minutes. These always relate to everyday life, and you listen to each recording twice with a short 30-second break. Then answer specific questions, and these often require you to write numbers or a short reply or a choice from a multiple choice list. Now, here are some common types of recordings used in the DELF A2 exam. Message from an answering machine, an extract from a radio show or a conversation on the radio, or sometimes an overheard dialogue in an everyday setting. In terms of scoring, it's set up like this. 5 points for the messages or instructions, 8 points based on the radio show, the radio conversation or a recorded announcement, and finally, 12 points for the conversation between native speakers. In part number 2, which is reading or compréhension écrite, you will be asked to read 3 or 4 short written documents. This part lasts 30 minutes and they will relate to everyday documents and written material that you see in your everyday life. You will need to answer questions to show your understanding, and these will often be multiple choice questions. Sometimes you'll need to justify your answer by quoting a sentence from the text. Here are some commonly used types of written material that you can expect to see in DELF A2. Recipes, instructions, emails, menus, leaflets, newspaper headlines, newspaper articles, announcements, signs, and or timetables. In terms of scoring, it's set up like this. 5 points to read signs, announcements, or instructions. 6 points to understand newspaper titles or a short newspaper article. 9 points to extract key relevant points from a document. And 5 points to get information out from a specific document. Alors, dites-moi, comment below this video. I would love to hear which skills you find the hardest and pourquoi. Is it listening, reading, speaking, or writing? I can't wait to see which one so I can help you further. The third part is the writing task called production écrite. Here, you will be producing 2 short written pieces and you'll have 45 minutes for this part. The first one will ask you to write about and describe an event or an experience. This one contains a handful of images, usually as prompts. It's called écriture créative, and you'll be marked out of 7 points. The second writing task will require you to write to thank someone, apologize to them, get information, or congratulate them. Sometimes you will be given an email and you'll need to write a short reply to express one of these. The second part is called correspondance. This one will be marked out of 6 points. You'll be asked to write 60 to 80 words for each exercise. Remember that one word can contain an apostrophe or a dash. For example, both j'ai, I have, and qu'elle, that she, count as one word each. So the first written task is 7 points, the second one is 6 points, and the remaining 12 points are split between vocabulary and spelling, grammar and syntax, and overall flow and coherence. That means that if your grammar isn't amazing or you feel that your vocabulary is a bit limited, it won't mean that you'll fail this part if you concentrate on the other elements too. For the final part of the DELF A2 exam, it's time to do the speaking part. En français, c'est la production orale. So this part of the exam is organized in 3 parts. Even though it only lasts 6 to 8 minutes plus some prep time, it's often the most feared part of the exam. So let me tell you how it looks so that you're well prepared. The first is a quick exchange of information called entretien dirigé, where you will introduce yourself or a personal topic. It's marked out of 4 points and lasts just a minute and a half. Nice and fast. No prep time for this one, but you will have 10 minutes to prepare the second and the third part of the speaking task. So the second part is called monologue suivi. And here, for 5 points, you will show that you can have a social exchange, talk about something related to you or your life, describe something familiar, as well as react and interact with someone. Finally, the third and last part is called exercice en interaction, which is a 3 to 5 minute role play. You will need to ask and give information, conduct a transaction or make suggestions and react during an exchange. This part is marked out of 6 points. So if you're keeping tabs, the marks are 4 points for part one, 5 points for part two, and then 6 for the third part. The remaining 10 points are awarded for your ability to showcase things like vocabulary, both depth of vocabulary and mastery, grammar and syntax, and pronunciation. To prepare for greater success, here are some recurring topics and situations that you'll often come across in the speaking part of the DELF A2 exam. For part one, we regularly see topics like home, leisure activities, family, sports, likes and dislikes, as well as work. For part two, it's usually around personal topics such as your studies, your profession, your favorite dish, a typical day for you, your city, or how you met a good friend. And in the third part, the role play will have you pretending that you are sending a parcel at the post office, organizing a weekend away with friends, joining a gym, planning a party, joining a local library, perhaps opening a bank account, discussing plans to study overseas, or buying tickets. And that's the fourth and last section of the DELF A2 exam for you. Not that bad, is it? Now, if you haven't watched my other videos yet on the French DELF A2 exam, a link to the playlist is in the description below right now. So make sure to go and check it out and get some help for these DELF exams so that you can put every chance on your side. Alors, Voilà, mes amis. Now you know exactly what the French exams look like and what to expect in each section so that you can be better prepared. But what if you're not sure what topics you need to review or what grammar points to practice? Well, I've created a free checklist just for the DELF A2 exam to show you exactly what you need to know. You can sign up for it. It's free. It's in the description below. I've put the link there for you, and it will help you assess what to focus your study efforts on. If you like this video, I'd be so grateful if you gave me a like below, subscribe to this channel, and share it with anyone else you know who is actively learning French and or preparing for French exams. And don't forget to comment below to let me know if this video was helpful for you and any questions you may have. I so look forward to seeing your feedback and help you further in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. Merci du fond du cœur. Thanks from the bottom of my heart. Finally, make sure you check out these extra videos on the French Speak YouTube channel to get more help for your French studies. If you enjoyed this video, the best way to say j'aime cette vidéo is by giving it a thumbs up and share it with another French learner you know. Merci d'avance.